What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about what's new with SmartDeploy. It has been a long time that I've used SmartDeploy and pushed out any videos to you guys, and SmartDeploy has been on the game with a lot of improvements on this particular deployment utility, so let's get right into it. All right, so I have my SmartDeploy app open on my server. And the first thing that I noticed when I finally upgraded this application was within computer management, they changed how everything looks. It looks much cleaner. I love the way that this thing looks. It's awesome. Another thing that I noticed was patch management. This actually gives you an option to push out Windows updates. And it also gives you the machine. And if they have any pending Windows updates, like for example, this machine right here has 3 and it's pending, it allows me to actually right click on it and then pick install updates. Now within install updates, you get this nice little dialog box, which gives you a couple options. You could do a local network or cloud network. And for additional options, it allows the user to defer for updates or schedule the deployment. I clicked on finish here. You get a confirmation. I clicked okay. Now within computer management, if you head back over there, on the computer, on the first column that you pushed out those Windows updates, you're going to see a nice little clock, and that's basically saying that something is happening to that particular machine. Now, I went inside that machine, and I did notice those three updates being pushed to it, which was awesome. And when I went back inside the patch management, I noticed that underneath the status column, it said installed. So I was like, oh, crap, that's pretty awesome. So when I went back inside the server, I didn't see those updates there anymore. And the updates were installed onto that server, which I was pretty impressed that SmartDeploy is actually doing that. Now within SmartDeploy, I noticed that software management was embedded into their software. This is pretty awesome. This gives you a bird eye view of all the apps that are within your environment. One cool thing about this is that you are able to select an app, right click on it, and it gives you additional options. You are able to view the clients, uninstall, upgrade, and edit the uninstall string or export. Now, what I did here, I actually picked clients to see what clients had this particular software. But the fact that I'm able to select software within the software management and upgrade it on the spot to those clients that have it, that's awesome. Now, within the computer management, I added another computer and I just wanted to see how everything works, how fast it picked up. Once you install the agent on a machine, it should talk to your SmartDeploy app and it should go inside your all computers node, which is good. From here, you're able to select one of the machines. It gives you more details on the machine, like what type of install software it has, any history, updates history, operating system, the manufacturer, the model, the processor. This right here is pretty awesome. It also allows you to do imaging on the spot, do drivers, apps, capture, deploy. You're able to join and rename everything in one interface. Now, this right here is what I consider a game changer. I believe SmartDeploy not too long ago joined with PDQ Deploy and they integrated their technology within SmartDeploy. And I think this is it. This is pretty awesome. There's a lot of things happening with SmartDeploy. Hopefully I could push out more videos for you guys. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.